Hefty with a couple of presentations on RSockets, for the questions of what RSockets is, and I think that it's for basically motivation, what got me to this. So this is my problem for you. Anybody who's ever programmed a verb, of course, simply that is the problem for the verb. So, very briefly, just walk through how to do a span here to verbs. Just a few slides, couple dozen here. Obviously, a lot of different parts of the objects. Two pairs, you set all this up. Messages, giving messages, I have to register in memory, I've still been stable topic at this conference, I call for registration. There's some two dots here with RDA, we have to post these messages on the two pairs before, we have some types of nets, and we're going to start with some data. And because I don't have enough time, we're going to assume I'm connected already, and now we have to pass some data. Again, on the front side, I still have to register data. You guys see this code? And then finally, I post a send message. And now, I want to know when the send's done. It's like, it's finished. Go to CQ. Right there. On the CQ, pull it again. Just here's the show up. Now I need to wait around for the event. Hopefully they come, so you can acknowledge the event. And then go back to pulling the CQ again. And at that point, I finally have some CQ. And it's just that. And this is better than the CQ. I haven't even done the RDA copy. So, that's the problem. Actually, in reality, what I was trying to do was upload data from one system to another, and you can put it in. And I didn't have IP or IP. But from that, the RSockets try to help solve this part of the problem. And so, everyone's favorite topic is adding in a new API access. And you can talk there. So, RSockets stands for RDA Socket API. Basically, the calls that go in today to track the white sockets, the net white sockets. They do byte streaming, which is what I would really kind of do, just like the socket. And they have support for non-blocking operations like sockets. So our goal here is I wanted something that is just like sockets, except it's not. Two main goals I have during development. So first of all, I want to support well-known programming concepts. Ideally, the likely to get to sit down, program to this without knowing anything about RDA. So they just need to know how to use sockets and they can sit down and start programming. Under ideal conditions, you have to support existing applications. Now I define ideal conditions as an application that is not called for. So I want to be able to have this interface perform as well as this native RDA implementation. So if you written your code to verbs, I want to sort of, is there any, what's the advantage to get from the cost side of courses that I have to do to the right I have an overview. All sockets, sit in the interface, the bottom, the RDMCM, and verbs. I actually practiced it as part of the RDMCM. Algorithm and protocol. turn to the ATM, dropped, and said, "Hey, don't open up." And we had a couple of things. We just didn't care if we just make a communication, so no current package is needed to get this work, so you don't have to wait. All the calls that we made with the socket, and I added a call at the beginning. So, that's it again. Just listen to the stuff. C, data transfers, send, receive, read, write, the support for continuous operations, for continuous operations, both for the whole select call, and the other operating call function, that the second socket option is worth. Started with the API and what calls it made with the socket. way it's not going to recall calls like read or write or read. I created a small library that I use to keep up the library between RSockets and Dell. This intercept all the socket calls, including all my key calls, and intercept file all your calls as well. And what it says with RSockets. Now, because function signatures are the same between RSockets and sockets, the Pure library, for most part, just has to accept if you have to do one of the pass down or not over the socket, you have to go through the list. And the other issue I found was when I started the new guy job, I intercept all socket calls, it doesn't really work, so I had constant callback support. And for connections, the callback to mobile TCP sites, and benchmarks and different API functionalities, things like carrier broadcast, data gathering, all kinds of type applications. So it's just a series of benchmarks that I run, and I run those same tests across the different processes. In this case, I did not show IP ID on these graphs, but it was fantastic in my voice, and it only builds on our sockets and IP ID. And it has the key as individual endpoints. So the results, so salt latency, the lower is better. But if you take a look at that graph, and you take out which one is reaching out from, so the areas are highlighted. That's places where our sockets actually outperform the other implementations. So these are 64 byte transfers and 4 byte transfers. I just put the two graphs for each of these based on the y-axis, so I can highlight the differences. So at least in some cases, the RSockets can compete with the IP benchmark against the open data. A couple other transfer sizes, 64K and 1 megabyte. If you've got larger transfer sizes, RSockets can compete against the major implementation. So, probably just the way the implementation is within the API, they've done something with the SOC implementation and the specific benchmark. You see, some of the benchmarks are looking at the better implementation in the data. Maybe two or three times. Also, all of the ones on the right hand side, those are the alternate benchmarks. And I move those along with the weights and numbers to higher, so otherwise it would be four together. So, yeah. This is Intel and Dell. This is, this is Intel NVI's lower-pay interface and the RSocket, which is the standard TCP interface that I use the pre-built library to develop the interface. Yeah. And they're actually lower-pay, so when you use your device, it's lower-pay. That's lower-pay interface. to work on a page or 16 or whatever it is. Yeah, I believe that any after man, I think you'd have to do a work on 16. So, this is running the drive on the keys to keep the socket for 2 meters. And now, so the intercept the socket calls. There's some overhead on your instruction. You just kind of overhead, it's easy to put in many ways to get the wind and push up and put it on. And so it's the wind pad, the trams, and the TWD, and the random access test. And so you can see the performance of our sockets versus reason. So if it's still facing the same, that's the outperformance of the TCM, the lower MFT, and the random access test. I bought the speaker last week, so I didn't have time to actually figure out why. So I think that's going to be the post. A lot of areas, even on the aero benchmarks, this compose, I don't know how well this will scale. So I've been still doing a lot of work to get the Willis 400 and some of the nodes and polymers. But at least what's possible to have a socket implementation on top of RDMA to have basic rights easily that would seem slide to work from the beginning. But these are areas where we can make an improvement. So I haven't tried to optimize it, but the one area I know exists is I do data copies. I do data copies on send and receive source implementation. So if I can do direct data replacement, that would be great. So I have an algorithm that I think would work to do direct data replacement. It doesn't involve changing the software of the smartphone in advance of some of the receivers. But the problem is most of the applications we're looking at use non-blocking calls. So if you use a non-blocking socket, non-blocking send, non-blocking receive, it makes implementing direct data placement extremely difficult. So basically, if I was a crosswalk receive side, I can't think of a way to do direct data placement on the receive side with a non-blocking call. On the send side, we do have some potential to do non-blocking on the send. So we take the data directly from the receive block to the zero and then work with that. Already know what alternative. So what I'm looking for is some way to add direct data placement calls to the RSockets interface that blends in with all these existing calls. But I want to keep things simple. I don't want to expose users to massive amounts of RDMA. I don't want to know what a TD is, a number between an HDA, a LID, a DIR, a password, or anything else that looks like RDMA. If you just know I'm doing a socket, you can send it to the C, or some other mechanism to do direct data placement. And finally, I'd like all the technologies to be able to use this. So, if I have a time management partner, I'd like them to make the same call. Or I'd like SSD, and have an SSD do the same thing. So, if you come up with some sort of extension that works with everything, I just want to have some way for you to optimize the code to take advantage of something, but still work as is. So now, this is stuff that's subject to discussion. We'll pick up some notes as well. I don't have any kind of this in the minutes or detail that involves sending to the node. And I suspect that it would get the performance that we want for the development of the code as well. But I'm looking for things that blend in with the existing problems. Here we have to talk about hiring concepts. So depending on what these look like, so I'll throw out a proposal that we can talk about what my person looks like. So I looked at all the existing calls. So went through all these calls, is there anything that the user may be familiar with that would help with the replication? chamber is not what I'm looking for, but we used to have a new size signature that we did be close to what I wanted. So we really not use the socket, but to kind of take those API things and do something to help come up with it. Read B and write B, so I'll have those implemented. I'll have the part of RSockets, they lag. They'll want to use your help with the collective system. So I want to take this memory and expose it across the connection to the next section. Well, that looks a lot like memory registration. So I specify on the map which is remote side and give it some offset. So if I specify an offset map, which is somewhat like a tile map in that case. And I have calls, I have to write using QB twice, then I'm overloaded. I have, again, a quick call, I simply map down to RDA read. Or you simply just move beyond and say, hey, this is another call.